Look at here. Don't tell me the whole friggin' river's blocked. Everybody, Trip Smith here on YouTube, and it's time for another adventure. This is a big one, baby, the biggest one yet. We're gonna be doing 118 miles down the Great Choctahatchee River. We're starting right here in Geneva, Alabama, headed all the way, hopefully, to Destin, Florida, all the way to the Gulf of Mexico. We're actually starting right at the Rock Dock campground. We're gonna be camping in just like a month and a half. It's gonna be awesome. We're at the Choctahatchee River, but then right up here is where the Pea River comes into the Choctahatchee. Oh, hold on. We're getting away from it. Oh boy, it's that shallow, huh? Woo-wee! Okay, the river's pretty shallow. I didn't realize it was gonna be that shallow. Let's go check out the Pea real quick. It's looking good. Ah, it's a beautiful part of the river. It really is. We are hitting the bottom. Good gosh. Is that shallow? All right, so now we just drifted right up into the Pea River. You see where these two rivers just come together right here at the confluence of good times and good people or something like that that I put on the t-shirts. So when I was putting in this boat ramp here in Geneva, I saw some old timers sitting around and they kind of took up a conversation with me real quick and we kind of chatted, told them what I was doing. Kind of looked at me like I was a little, you know, not necessarily crazy, but adventurous, I guess you could say. And so I started asking them questions, you know, what do I need to worry about? Well, they were quick to point out that the river may be shallow. And I was thinking I wasn't gonna have to worry about that. But I believe that is gonna be a pretty major concern, at least in the beginning of this trip. I have spotted a few snags here and there and stuff. And I do remember years ago, whenever I hit this section, I do remember it being shallow in a few spots. One of the things they asked me, they said, well, how are you gonna not hit all the snags and trees and stuff on along the way? I was like, I guess I'm gonna be gambling. But I didn't think it was gonna be that big of a deal. Hopefully it won't be. Maybe we'll gamble and win. But we got a long way to go. Right now we're coming up on a spot that I got a lot of memories at, or one major memory at. Right here, this big sandbar just south of Geneva. That's where I camped years ago on my first kayak camping video that I made. And really my first kayak camping trip. Pretty awesome. That was a really good campsite. That might be a little hangout spot during Rocket Dock right there. Yeah, I camped right up there under that tree. Very awesome. But we gotta get underway. We got miles to make, springs to see. We've got the beautiful Gulf to get to. It's really gonna be an action-packed trip because we have Morrison Spring to hit and then two other springs I've never seen before that you can like only get to by boat. And they're not very widely known. And I've been wanting to hit them for a long time. You can't really paddle to them very well, but it's Ginu. Well, get me there, baby. It's gonna be great. All right, let's get rolling. Let's get rolling. I want some cool, clear waters. You know what, right here in the middle of the river, I think it's time for a trip dip. Okay, I guess I gotta do it like that. It's a little shallow right here. Like, really shallow right here in the middle of the river. Fortunately, though, I did slow down right as I was coming up on this spot because I remembered from years ago when I came around this bend. I know, crazy how you remember the little things like that. I remember seeing, like, little bitty shoals. Remember I talked about them just a minute ago? It was right here. I felt the motor kind of bump, felt the boat slow a little bit, and I was like, whoop, here we go. So I throttled back, and sure enough, I look down, even though the water is not super clear, you can still see the bottom. That's all right, we got a shallow running boat. We just hope we don't hit a log or something in this shallow water, especially running like 25 mile an hour, which is my cruising speed. Perfect time for a trip dip, right? Who doesn't want a trip dip at 8:30 in the morning? Makes you a little nervous cruising this far at this speed in this shallow water. Hey, turtle. Oh well, always an adventure, right? Yeah. Otter on the bank over there, hiding in the grass. There he goes. There he goes. Get it, buddy.
I ain't gonna mess with you. Just wanna check you out, man.
I don't know if y'all can see them, but right back there, there were some sticks and logs under the water. You can kind of see where the water is disturbed in places, and you say, okay, that looks like there could be something right under the water. As the current's going over it, it's kind of churning the water. Maybe I should slow down. So I did. I slowed down pretty good ways back there. And what do you know, right after I slowed down, I felt a little bump on the skeg. Is that what it is? The skeg of the motor. So I slowed down. But like, see these places like right here? You don't want to hit that moving. And I see them under me right now. Hold on, watch. Oh, there it went. There it went. There it goes. There it goes. There it went. A little plinko. Pink, 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 pink. That right there definitely makes you nervous, cruising down the river. I'm thinking, okay, is it 6 inches deep here? Is there a stump right here? Is there a tree right here? You know, you're thinking that going down the river for a while. So until I get further down the river, like a little ways past I-10, like one of the old timers told me. On the south side of I-10,
you're gonna hit a stretch. There's a lot of old throw down timber, shallow water, and swill. You'll handle it, but it's not a piece of cake.
Right. Not gonna be very comfortable. I'm not gonna be very calm and relaxed, so we gotta get through that. All right, coming up on our first little milestone or mile marker down the river. This is Highway 2. We've gone 8.3 miles. Let me show y'all my maps while we're sitting here cruising through all the, I don't know, the minefield. So map-wise, I've just got on Google Earth and printed this stuff out. I kind of showed a little bit more of this on Instagram. So check out my story, Trip Out There. You'll find some of this information before it even hits. So this is it. This is my kind of overall map. We're starting up here. I cruise all the way down here and all the way over to the Gulf right here through the bay and stuff in this area. I've got Geneva, Alabama to the Gulf of Mexico, 118 miles, blah, blah, blah. Then I have here each little mile marker and how far it is between each point. So 8.3 miles to that bridge right up there from Geneva to Highway 2. So then we've got Highway 2 to Highway 90. So I have this grand map, and I've also got an upper and lower map, so two different sections of the river, so I can see a little bit more detailed. So it's basically the same thing, just zoomed in. Of course, you don't really need a map, you know, when you're going down the river to the Gulf, because it kind of only goes one way. Except maybe when it gets down to the end, it's got a lot of little fingerlings and stuff, kind of like in the river delta. But we got a map so we can kind of see where we are, and we don't miss any of our stops along the way. And I'm kind of a map weirdo. I really like looking at maps, and I spend a lot of time on Google Earth and stuff, so I enjoy just looking around here. Okay, it's super shallow right here. May have to kill the engine. Too shallow. All right, let's pull her a little bit. Oh, what's that? Bilge pump. Something. Turn the bilge on. Baby. I'm ready to get out of all this shallow stuff. I don't like it at all. Oh my goodness, check this out. What is this thing? I know everyone's thinking, oh my goodness, we're in a PFD. What is going on? Yep, I'm putting a PFD on. You know, I've gotten a lot of flack about not wearing a PFD on the boat and stuff, but I've always said, whenever I feel like there might be some danger and I need to wear a PFD, I'll absolutely wear one. And so right now, hey, I'm trying to cruise at speed, trying to make some time. I got a long way to go today, so I'm going to put on my PFD because what if I do hit a tree or a stump or something and I'm in deeper water? I might want to wear this. Granted, I may hit one and be in 6 inches of water, but still, putting it on. There you go. How about a thumbs up for putting on the PFD, all you folks who were concerned in the past, all right? There's a lot of these little houseboats. I know we're gonna see more and more as we go down. I wonder if any of them are Airbnb. Wouldn't that be sweet? It'd certainly be a fun weekend in a, you know, one that's, you know, habitable. That doesn't look so good. Somebody's 3-hour tour didn't go very well. Gilligan! Hello, we stopped.
There's a lot of shallowness you gotta watch out for. Oh gosh, I'd have gone the wrong way. Be trapped in all this junk. Yeah, I'm ready for this junk to be behind us, baby. We've been on the water an hour and 15 minutes. We've only gone 11 and a half miles. That's not very good. That's not very good. Okay, look at that big old gar. Good Lord. Or sturgeon one. It's huge something. I know you guys couldn't see it. I wasn't lying though. It was there. I just spotted some clear water coming into the river. I mean clear water. Like, you know, the kind of clear water that we like. Look at that. Right up here, baby. Oh yeah, this is the good stuff. Oh, I didn't know about this one. Oh yeah, this is what we come for, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on, slow down, baby. Look at here. Look at here. Oh, what a beautiful day. She flowing pretty good too. Man, right there is the blue hole. Y'all thinking what I'm thinking? I bet you are. I bet you are. Killer. Look at here, look at here, look at here. Woo-wee! That is beautiful, y'all. Even got a little rope swing up there. It's actually a cable swing. That's killer. Killer, killer, killer. Let's go. Get in. Although it's not real hot yet. So I'm thinking about going off the rope swing, but my gosh, it's pretty high. I think I'm gonna do it anyway though, you know. Gotta take some risk, right? It's not like we're not already taking a ton of risk out there on the river today. That felt great. I forgot to get a trip dip. Oop. But the boat started drifting on me. Okay, I didn't know where I was going to land. So we may have to do that again. Is that a bug on me? Dang sure is. Something biting me. A yellow fly. Them jokers are bad. If you don't know about yellow flies, they're some bad boys. This is high. Woo! Ha! But it's still awesome. That's great. All right, now let's go check out underwater. Made a little rookie filmmaker's mistake. I jumped in the spring before I filmed in it. So now it's a little murky, but whatever. We're gonna go, because we don't have a lot of, well, I don't know how much time we have. Cruising. I'm on pins and needles, just standing up, kind of tense the whole time. Can't really relax and enjoy things because you're driving and you'll see a stump go by or a tree go by in the water and you're just like, whoop! But we're making it. We're making it. I am warming my lunch up down here. Got some Boston butt right there, baby. Getting warm in the sunshine. Mmm! So we made it to I-10, pretty freaking huge. But the next couple miles is what one of the older gentlemen warned me about. He said there were a lot of snags between right after this. So I don't know how there could be any more than there have been, because man, it has been tense, y'all. I'm ready to be done with this. Okay, we got a little problem here. Hold up. Don't tell me the whole friggin' river's blocked. Okay, it looks blocked that way. It looks like it probably blocked that way. All right, I gotta figure this out. In the current, in the trees. All right, I'll be back. Oh boy. All right, I got the boat tied off. Doesn't look good. Oh, okay. All right, there's a little island right here, it appears. And I think the other side is definitely blocked. Man. This side is not good. Holy moly. This ain't good, y'all. This ain't good at all, really. Look at this. Holy cow. So I'd have to... What's beyond it? All right, I gotta figure this out. I mean, I might could get over a few logs, maybe, but I gotta make sure that beyond it is clear, because if I get between, I'll really be really screwed. All right, so if I get through that mess, I probably can get under that. But the current and all you gotta deal with, and it's kind of a heavier boat than a kayak, that's a freaking risky situation. I mean, that's if I can get over this stuff. I mean, I probably can. It's gonna be hard work. Man. All right, I may go look at the other side. Okay, I'm actually getting a little lucky right here, because even though most of the water goes that way, where I just walked, and then a little bit more of the water goes that way, there's still a big river over here to the side that looked like a dead end to me from down there. Holy moly, That would have been a crazy friggin' video. See me pull some stupid stuff like that. But I think we're gonna make it. Gosh, y'all, that really had me worried for a minute. That really had me worried. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, that was, woo! 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 Man, all right. Let's just hope this one's not stopped up somewhere. Already run aground, but that's okay. I'd rather be in shallow sand than hauling over friggin' logs. Sheesh. Always an adventure. Glad we didn't try that mess. Ooh, it'd have been bad. All right, let's hope we don't run up on anything else like that. I tell you what, that gentleman knew what he was talking about. This is the worst part of the river, for sure. I mean, like, look right there. You see that? The stump just right under there, a log. There's more. See, they're everywhere. Oh, crappers. Like right there. That I almost went into because I was trying to film. Whew, I probably wouldn't suggest this. And I probably won't be doing this trip again. I don't know. It's, oh, man. Hope that's not blocking the whole river. It's just risky. You risk damaging your equipment a pretty good bit on a boat. And I wouldn't want to paddle it. No, it'd be boring. It just, no good. Whoops. Okay. Glad I didn't pull my kill switch off. I'd hate to lose that. Uh-oh. I think I passed Morris in spring. Yeah, I did. It wasn't very long ago, but... It's a pretty nice one right there. Slide, a grill, air conditioner, hot water heater, Is that a tankless hot water heater? Wow. There's some pretty cool ones. It'll be fun to stay in. All right, Boston butt's pretty warm. I say it's lunchtime. It's almost 1 o'clock. Just passed a gator, a little bitty baby one. Yeah, I think we might go see him. He's right up there. Oh, he just came back up. Come on, buddy. Hold on now. He's going, there he is. He gone. All right, I'm looking on my GPS, on my phone, and my GPS, and I can't really tell where I'm at. I can't see specific enough. I don't know. We're trying to find the spring. Hopefully, we can find it. Okay, now we found it. Right after I just saw a big old gator, probably about 8 foot, maybe 9 foot. But you want to know how I know this is the right place? Because look at the water. See how muddy it is? And now look at the water. See how clear it is? That's how you know we're at the right place. Anywhere there's clear water, that's where I belong, all right? There's actually two springs back here. Man, look at that. Oh. Great, great, great. I've wanted to come to this spot for a long time. I knew it wasn't feasible on a kayak or a paddleboard, but it's feasible on the Oginu, baby. Oh, man. Cool. Man, it's pumping out of there. Let's get in. Let's get in.
Uh-oh.
Oh. We missed it. Well, I think it's safe to say that this is a pretty awesome spot. And like I said, off the beaten path. Like, there aren't many people who know about it. It's not like some other springs that just get overloaded. Because you can only get here by boat. And it's, you really need to know about it. So, where is this place? I don't know, it's on the Choctaw River. Do your research. I guess. You can find us. It's not too hard. There we go. Oh, maybe it'll be a little better. All right. Check it out. Not as clear as other springs, but it's still a spring. It is a really big hole, though. Thank you. feels like we got a little thundercloud out there. Oh, it's all right. So there's another creek that feeds into this, that's part of this system with another spring up it, and I want to go try and see it. I think it's a little farther than this one, but hey, we got a Ginu, we can do it. So it's awesome. I heard it gets really shallow, but we'll see. We'll see. Here's our fork in the road. Maybe we need to go this way. Oh, onward! Oh wow, this is awesome. It opens up to a huge crystal clear lake. This is pretty awesome. Like the whole lake is... pretty doggone clear. Pretty shallow, but it's clear. Sunglasses just got knocked off. They fell in the boat. Y'all, this is a long way back in here. This is a long way. You wouldn't paddle this against the current this far. No, not and enjoy it. Oh, what is that over there? See some sand. And dead in there. This is gonna be it, baby. This is gonna be it. Back in there, a little bit of white stuff. Oh, Lord. Excuse me. Oh, boy. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Oh, gosh, this is not good. Oh, there we go. Little bump. Well, we're going to have to come back to this spring another day. There was there were some people there. And let's just say I interrupted. And we'll leave it at that. And I was like, oh. Excuse me, I'll come back another time. All right, we'll get on back down the river. No harm, no foul. Everybody got a good laugh out of it. And the funny thing is, I had the camera going as I was coming around you. I was coming up to the spring head. I might have edited that out, for sure. Always an adventure, right? Alright, I need to pay attention. Alright, see y'all. I gotta get out of here.
It's starting to rain a little more. Good, I've seen it all now. Seen it all. I knew it was gonna rain a little bit. Thunder and lightning is not too bad right now. If I get skimmed back, it's really gonna be chilly. Alright, coming back to the river. Hope some folks back there are. Oh man, y'all see that lightning? Woo! Y'all see me jump? I'm on the camera. Alright, I'm gonna pull over right up here. Boat's going up in water. Alright. We're in. We're good chance here, technically. I wanna get closer to the bay so we can get that early run. Across the bay in the morning.
Right here, ground a frog, yo. Alright, so the lightning's getting closer. This can be a good little time for me to share something with y'all. What do you do in a lightning storm? Get somewhere low. If you're not by trees, you can help it. Off the water, and eventually you can sit down. So what you can do is get your life jacket, your PFD, put on the ground, to insulate you from the ground. Put on the PFD, you got it, and you can sit just like this. That's all you can really do. It's not a whole lot, but that's all you can do. That's all you can do.
The boat is pretty, got a lot of water in it. I'm gonna start pumping it out. There's some of my hatches or some of the compartments in there. That stuff's probably underwater. I'm gonna start pumping it out. I have a bilge pump, but I'm just gonna pump it, generate body heat, and it'll save some electricity. All right, I got her all pumped out. See what the damage is. Okay, it's this compartment, which is good, I guess. This is where I want to keep dry. Okay, I just noticed some water somewhere else. Oh, up here, under my front deck, I've got a box with my battery in it. It's got a good bit of water in it. So we'll get that out too with the sponge, I guess, instead of dumping it back in the boat. Hope the battery's all right. I think it will be. Something else I noticed when I came back to the boat, my gas tank was floating. It's very close to empty. I'm going to go ahead and top it off. I've got 2 gallons under where I'm sitting right now. Then I have an extra 7 gallons under the front. So I'll probably use 3 and 2 or something. But I have a special gas can out there I'll show you guys. Well, that's doing pretty good. I got this collapsible gas can. This thing's capacity is like 8 gallons or something. It's quite a lot. We've only got 3 in it, and I can kind of compress it and get it into a smaller compartment up under the front, just, you know, really take advantage of all the room. So pretty cool. Just gonna be interesting to see how she pours. Not very good. Whoa, good gracious alive. Okay, I need a spout for this joker. Okay, I'm gonna fill her up. Other than being difficult to pour, one thing I really like about it is how when you're done with it, it just collapses down small and stores easily. I'm gonna clean up that mess. I didn't spill with like, I don't know, a decent amount. My calculations are correct. Have about 2 more miles to go to the bay. So, basically, what we're gonna have to do is just try to find a decent campsite. It's like down here near the delta. Like, there's a lot of fingers of the river that kind of opens up when it empties out into the bay. And at like the end of one of those, or somewhere, there's a pretty good, supposed to be a fairly open spot to camp, nice and clean. I'm gonna try to find that. I've got some decent amount of sunlight left to try to find it, so see what we can do. Alright, one thing I definitely gotta do, I gotta clean my glasses. And if you guys remember in the last video, I think I mentioned I wanted to get something. Well, I got it. I got a little bitty sunglass cleaning kit. So, we got a little bitty microfiber towel in there. Then a little spritzer. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Gets all the oils and stuff off, I hope. But you know, you got sunblock that gets on your glasses and just anything else. So let's see how it does. Oh, yes, that is fantastic.
Yeah, exactly. Ooh, smells good too, like apple. And it's got pictures of apples on it. So I guess it's scented. Yeah, I can smell the glasses. Okay, pretty cool, I guess. It's kind of stupid, but whatever. Wraps around here. In the cap. This goes right back on there. Sweet. It came in a packet too. I'll put a link in the description below if you guys want to check it out on Amazon. It's pretty darn cheap and nice. Okay, we made it to the bay. I'm not really sure what to do now. We're gonna figure it out. At least it's calm out here. All right, so looking on Google Earth, I came out where I wanted to come out pretty much. Here, cause like there's a bunch of like rivers that come out into the bay at like 10 different places. And at the ends of those, at the Delta, there's maybe some sand in a few of them. So we're gonna try and find where to camp, maybe some trees. I don't know, we're gonna go look around. I don't really know. There's a little clearing right up here through the reeds. Let's see here. I don't think that's really good for... No. All right, we're going to move on. We're just cruising out here. There are not to camp. There aren't many. But I know if I go to the south side of the bay, I get to the ICW, I can kind of crawl up in there, or somewhere along there, I can find some land to get on. I think it's somewhere right along in here. Slip on these little beaches, kind of clean under there. And we're literally just like right inside the ICW from the bay. What about right there? This is us right here, baby, I think. The beach is smaller than I wanted it, but it's open up under there. Looks like I can find a spot for a hammock pretty easily. Kill switch. Now there's one thing that I'm kind of worried about. It's the intercoastal waterway, so a lot of times there can be barges going up and down it. Sometimes they might create a big wake. And that may not be so good for the Ginu. So that's going to be interesting tonight. I'm probably going to try to pull the boat up as much as I can. And I'm going to check the tide too, because all that plays a factor. But I think it'll be all right, really and truly. And the water here is like really shallow, so I mean, it's not like it can sink very far. Holy cow. I just on the phone with my wife and I heard something. And I got some dolphins about to swim over here. They're right over there. Holy moly. They're over there feeding or something. Look. Oh, they come close. There's one over there. And one right there. Huh. That's pretty cool. Pretty freaking cool. Excellent. He's just a little baby crab. Even if he was a big one, I forgot my net. Whatever. We got other things for supper. And we've kind of got a nice little sunset-ish. We don't get to see the sun. We get to see a nice red sky at night. Sailor's delight. All right, let's eat. I'm hungry. Got our food bag here. See what we got. I know what we were supposed to have, or what I was thinking we would have tonight. That was my last packet gourmet, but had a little bit of extra leftovers at home. So let's dig into the old Red Paddle Co. cooler. A little bag of Boston Butt right here. My mom just texted me. Hey, by the way, Mom, thank you so much for
dropping me off today. And my wife, Ashley, thank you so much for coming and picking me up in 2 days. All right, here we go. I'd like a shout out. Oh, and they both got me this awesome watch for Father's Day. Totally, totally cool. All right, cooler's good. Oh yeah, there's not much in the cooler here. I've got like a bunch of frozen Life Waters and one green tea. No ice. You know what? I really didn't bring many snacks. Actually, I lied. I brought two Clif Bars. We'll have a white chocolate macadamia nut. Clif Bars aren't my favorite nutritional wise, but my wife got a box on sale, so I'm eating them. I do like this kind of dinner because it's so simple. It's all cooked, no prep or anything. Just eat it. I do enjoy that a lot.
It's pretty nice. Pretty nice. Y'all, I'm lucky to be doing stuff like this. I want to thank each and every one of you, subscribers, viewers, everybody, for watching. If y'all weren't watching, I wouldn't be doing this. Thank y'all so much. But I want y'all to do the same thing. Y'all can do this. I don't know, this one, I wouldn't suggest this one. But you guys can do some cool stuff. I would suggest coming down the chocolate hatchie like I did. Nah. I know y'all can't see me, but y'all can see that light down there? Got some sort of boat or something coming. Hope it's a big barge, but hope it's not somebody small who's gonna like come right up on me. Whatever it is, they're shining right on me. Well, it's either a big barge or a big freighter. Looks like a barge. Empty. It's floating really high. I guess we'll see what kind of wake it makes. I don't think it's making a big one. Yeah, it looks like just a little wake. That's comforting to know. All right, well, I'm in bed. Got my frog suit on. Oh, got my stuff sack pillow. Bug net and case. Bug head net. I'm ready to go. 9:20. Good gracious. It's going to be a good morning. Can't wait to get across that bay. That's going to be nice. Night-night.
Good morning. Whew, not quite burst light, but we get to see the sunrise. This green suit didn't do very well against the mosquitoes last night, I'll tell you that. Certainly not as well as it has in the past, so I don't know, I'm losing faith in it. Alright, we gotta get a move on. Oh yeah.
Sorry, no trip dip first thing this morning. I did remember it, but that stingray being out there and early in the morning, you never know. That might be foolish. Oh, look at that sunrise. Yeah. I gotta get going.
All right, I got camp broken down. Boat's cleaned up pretty good. Kind of cleaned all the stuff from the sticks and all the leaves and stuff that fell in it yesterday. Because now it's a nice, beautiful beach where the only thing I have to worry about really is beautiful white sand. Just got two more things to do before camp. First thing, put on some sunblock. That's something I haven't really talked about much in past videos, but it's super important. Something I'm always doing. I carry sunblock in my truck. I mean, I carry it with me all the time and I'm always putting it on because I have neglected that in the past and I've kind of paid for it. I've got these like sunspots and stuff right here around my eyes where if I get too much sun exposure, they'll get dark. People will be like, Trip, you got some dirt or something on you. I'm like, nah, it's just sunspots. And I've got a little something on my eye. I forgot what it's called from not wearing sunglasses long ago because I used to do a lot of construction work outside and never wore sunblock and hung out at the beach and stuff a lot. But the sunblock that I've really come to enjoy because it works is Blue Lizard Australian Sunscreen. No, they didn't pay me to say that or anything. I haven't ever even talked to the company. I've tried to, but I haven't been able to get in touch with them. But they got really good stuff. It's different than other sunblocks because it's not a chemical sunblock. It's a like physical sunblock, I believe is how they say it. It's the actual materials in it that are blocking the sun. They also have it like sensitive that we put on our kids and stuff. My wife wears it. Sometimes she gets burnt and she's like, I should use the Blue Lizard because it actually works. So, I mean, it does. It actually works. So I'm going to put this on. It's a little tough to rub in, but That's because it's a real freaking sunscreen. Wear your sunscreen, people. Wear your sunscreen. A lot of people don't learn that lesson until it's too late. Kind of like I did, in a way. But I've been wearing it for quite a few years, but there were quite a few years when I didn't wear any. Silly me. The next thing I gotta do is have some breakfast. I picked out something kind of fun, like I always kind of do, try to find some interesting food. I was at Rural King a while back and I saw some things. I was like, that would be good for a camping trip. So I picked some up a couple days ago. Right here we've got Farmer Select Old Fashioned Jalapeno Pickled Eggs. I've had pickled eggs one time from a gas station and they were friggin' horrible. Like, oh, the one bite I could stand was horrible. So, but it was red. People say, oh no, Trip, you can't eat that kind. That's horrible. So, I mean, I really, really, really love eggs. Like, I eat eggs like pretty much every single day, like 8 of them for breakfast. So, we'll see. And I love jalapenos. Smells like vinegar with a little bit of jalapeno. I mean, not my favorite, but I mean, it's not real bad. The eggs are a little tough. I'm not sure how many I'll be able to eat. We got breakfast. I wanted eggs. I need some Pack and Gourmet breakfast ones. They got some killer eggs that are actually good that you cook in a little pot. It works. Come here. We gotta get a roll on. 6:53 right now. The bay's looking pretty good out there. The wind's in our favor, coming from our backs. That'll be good. I think it's gonna be a good little crossing this morning. I'll let y'all see how beautiful it is where I'm going. It's freaking, it's awesome.
First pull, baby. Wow, we got a rainbow. Guess that means we could have some showers.
See the rainbow? Maybe you probably can't. There's a little bitty rainbow.
I gotta ride a boat trip.
We got 26 miles to go, two big bridges to go under, a lot of open water. We should be able to make that in a little over an hour. Or maybe even a little under an hour, depending on how fast I wanna go.
Got the map out because it's rough right here than I thought, so I needed to find a few places to sneak in if it gets so bad. I'm getting a lot of water in the boat. A lot of water in the boat. All right, I had some fuel cans, two red ones, 4 gallons of fuel up in the front. I ended up moving them back, moving the cooler back, trying to bring more weight to the rear of the boat, aft, to get the bow up, make it ride a little better in the waves. I think it's working because. Do you see I put the life jacket on? Woo!
Safe harbor right over there. Yes.
It's good because we're almost out of fuel.
That would have been a bad place to run out of gas out there. Got a little hairy there a few times. We don't have much further to go. That's good. One more, like, open stretch.
I stopped right under where I believe an oscar nest, and he's not very happy with me.
Or she, whoever it may be.
Keep screaming at me.
All right, it's time to get back after it. I know it looks like all calm and no big deal,
But you get out there, and the waves start building up. You're not quite out that way. The waves are, I mean, they're not real big. But it doesn't take really big waves to do a number on this Yinu. I mean, you really get soaked. And people have sunk them, like, legit, sunk them a lot, kind of, sort of. It's the one thing I kind of don't like about the Yinu. Yeah, really the one thing is that it's not very seaworthy in rough water. So I wish I had a boat that was both. I could go in small creeks and stuff, but could also handle some rougher water. I need that in my life. We made it! We're Destin, Florida! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Great. We didn't sink. We didn't break the boat or tear anything up coming down the river. Didn't sink in the bay. How awesome is that? Let's see, how are we doing here? On our old GPS. 124 miles, baby. Not too bad. Nah.
I don't know how close we're going to get to the actual Gulf, but it's not far right up there. Pretty swelly out here.
Alright, we were able to sneak out here right at the end of the pass. Gulf of Mexico, right here, folks.
We did it. But hey, the video's not over for sure. Still got some good times to have. Right back here. Trust me.
Right now it is looking kind of nasty. Back that way. Whoop! Y'all see that good stuff? Might turn the lights on. Oh boy. Alright, we're gonna head back into the harbor.
This is pretty far off. I don't know which way it's going. Hopefully not this way.
So right now I'm coming to the harbor. I'm trying to find somewhere to get. I think that's coming this way, for sure. I don't really know. I'm not familiar with being on the water out here, so I don't know where you can go and dock and hang out. But surely I can find a spot for this itty bitty boat. All right, I spotted a little bit of beach up here. Just go ahead and take refuge up there. Surely somebody will feel bad for me or something and be like, dude, come up here in your little boat. All right, I think this would be a good spot to ride off the storm. Get the boat beach. I can get up under this building right here. Kind of like a hobo or something. We'll let this storm pass, and there's some pretty cool stuff I want y'all to see. Like, this is like paradise. I mean, I say that about a lot of places, but this place is pretty sweet. And I haven't had anything else for breakfast except those 4 eggs, and that's certainly not enough. It's almost 10 o'clock now. I forgot I brought some bacon jerky. You guys ever had bacon jerky? Look at that. That is legit. Bacon, y'all. Good. So I go to walk up under here and there's friggin' sand spurs. Oh! Bunch of them. Watch this. Oh! Oh! Oh, yeah. Great.
Sweet.
So we're gonna ride out the storm. Now be quiet now. Alright, get these sand spurs out. Been raining for a while. Starting to flood up for the most part. To see how much water's in the boat. That's not too bad. We can get most of it out just by pulling the plug because it's higher in the boat than it is out of the boat. Alright, it's lunchtime. Let's go eat. Boat hands. Alright, I got some good food in my belly. The weather is clear. It's looking beautiful out here. Let's go find a little piece of paradise. Holy moly, look at all the freaking sea gnats. That's what we call jet skis. And like the gnats of the sea, they're always just pesking in your way. Sea gnats. So now we're headed to a little place just across from the harbor called Crab Island.
a popular hangout that I've never hung out at.
Now I'll go ahead and tell you folks that this was a slow day. The next day I was here and it was packed. But there's all kind of stuff. Look, seafood and Mexican food. Jet skis, paddle boards, t-shirts. You got daiquiris, pulled pork, chicken fingers, turkey burgers, volleyball, margaritas, beef burgers, even a little ice cream spot. And you got a general store, you can get floats and goggles and all sorts of nonsense. And then they have this sweet, awesome obstacle course you can make a fool of yourself on. And then, if you really want to get hurt, come play on this. Actually, that probably would be a good time. And I don't know what this is, but hey, it's out here.
So I pull up here on Crab Island thinking, now what if I can meet some folks and make some friends? Well, I'm usually pretty good at that. And what do you know, as soon as I've tossed the anchor out, somebody's like, what's the story on that thing? I'm like, well, I came all the way from Geneva, Alabama. They were like, what? And I was like, hold on, be right over and we'll talk about it. So it's going to be a good day. It's going to be a good day. Making friends. Hope to meet everybody here. Wouldn't that be cool? Oh, yeah. Forgot this. Trip dip! Got to get one of those in, right?
Lucky for me, the friends I made, they got the pontoon boat with the slide. These people are great. They said, I won't sue you. Oh, this is awesome. Check it out. We got a slide. I'm going. Here we go.
I mean, it was my birthday. I had to do it.
A little shallow.
So we're good.
Thank y'all.
I just had an idea. I don't know if it'll work yet, but I'm trying to figure it out. Can we sleep on the boat out here tonight? That'd be pretty cool, right? Let's see if I can figure it out. I think it might be possible with what I've got. So I think we're at camp. Why not? Crab Island is a beautiful place. Why not camp here tonight? Let's go ahead and have some dinner. It is 6 o'clock. Bacon, meat sticks. Oh, good old summer sausage. I'm voting for the bacon meat sticks. Another Rural King find. Doesn't taste like bacon, but it tastes like really, really good ham. Good enough for me. Dinner. No, I don't have any cake for my birthday or anything like that, but I do have another white chocolate macadamia nut. My cake was that Bushwhacker earlier. Oh, it's like a milkshake. So good. And I love chocolate. I really do. So I think I'm going to do it. I'm going to sleep on the boat. A good thing about it, we don't have to worry about bugs tonight. It's going to be fantastic.
Something about a boat sitting on the sea, out there in the wind, floating on the free. Jig around the world.
It's what I'm born to do, y'all, right here.
Gives a man hope. Something about a boat. Something about an old guitar. And the way it still sings. After all the smoky bars and the broken strings. They takes a whole lot of something, not of nothing at all.
It's something I can do. I can make a whole lot of something out of nothing at all. That's what you gotta do in life. Sometimes you gotta know how to make a lot of something out of nothing at all. It's a pretty good lesson, old Mr. Buffett singing right there.
So, trip dip. Why don't we jump in the water? All right, folks, good night. I'm going to sleep. Laying on the cushion here and legs out there on the cooler. See you in the morning.
What's up? Good morning. The tide has shifted. I just woke up to it. We just bumped into the general store here.
How about a little rip dip? All right, we got to get out of here.
Yeah, I'm about to get wet. I already guess this is the spot right now. A little squall coming through. So for breakfast, I'm having a muscle milk, or I've had a muscle milk. And I'm going to have some pork rinds. These are Max Golden Cracklings. This is with a skin attack, the good stuff. So I've been just sort of chilling in the shade. Not really doing a whole lot. Waiting on the wife to come pick me up, really and truly. My battery on the boat is kind of dead. It's really, really low. I went to trim the motor up because I pulled up here this morning. It didn't really work very well. So, that's not very good. The battery that I do have is a small one, though. It's, I don't know. Actually, I'm not about to get it out. I mean, bigger than a lawnmower battery, but smaller than a car battery. I don't know. I kind of did use the bilge pump a lot yesterday when I was coming across the bay. So I guess that used a lot of the juice and also, I guess, trimming up and down. I don't know. It's probably an old battery, the battery that came with the boat. So I'm probably going to have to get a new battery. Probably should get a new battery. Other than that, the boat did freaking awesome. So much fun cruising in this thing. Other than that, y'all, it was a great trip. I freaking loved it. Thank y'all for watching. Thank you, subscribers, patrons. Thank you all. I'll see y'all. Rock and Doc, take care. God bless. And oh, yeah, get out there. Do something like this. It doesn't have to be this extravagant or this daring of an adventure. Just get out there and enjoy the beautiful water. Destin, Florida, good place to be. See you, folks.
And he was from Opelika, Alabama.
Okay.
You can go about 7 or 8 miles up this river.
Uh-huh. I've been there.
Okay. You know where the Bellwood Bridge is?
Uh-huh.
All right, he is right below the Bellwood Bridge. Now, that's rough as a cob up there.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Nasty.
That boy turned his... I'm talking after him now. He turned his kayak over 5 times. He was wet. His cell phone wouldn't work. He asked me, he said, can I borrow your cell phone and call my wife, tell her to come get me?
How long ago was this?
Do you remember?
Yeah, I remember the guy who came over and laid on that table.
Yeah, I came back and found him.
Yeah.
I came back about 4 hours later. I got here when his wife. I tried everything. I tried to take him to a restaurant and everything, but do. Oh, Lordy.
That's,
6 months?
Yeah, probably.
Oh, that. Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
6 months. But that'd put it back in the winter, though.
It would. Well, cooler. Yeah, it would put it back in the winter.
I don't remember.
It's been a pretty good while.
It probably was about last November, really.